Hi, Jayanam here with a step-by-step beginner guide for getting started with hair in Blender 2.8. This time I remove the default cube because I want to use a sphere as a hair emitter. I press Shift and A to add it. The shading I set to smooth. I use the default material and set the color for this to a bluish tone, for instance. Okay, then it's time to set the viewport shading to render preview. The renderer is Eevee by default. I select this point light here and press Shift and E to duplicate it, so that I have two lights in the scene, but I guess I will add another light source later on. Alright, now I select the sphere and go here to the Particle Properties tab, add a new particle system, and instead of using emitter, I set it to hair, and boom, here we have it. Hair particles visible in the scene. Great, but they are very long, so I reduced the length. I set it to about 0.3, 0.4. That looks good. The next section is render. Let's see, the material is set to the default material. That's fine. And then we can increase the render steps a bit, but that's optional. So you can see step by step, the next section is viewport display. Here is nothing to do, so we go to the children, and here I select interpolated, and this changes everything. Look at this. Here you can set the amount, the number of children for the display and for the render. I increase it a bit for the display, for the render it is even higher. The other settings I keep as they are, but I like to change to a bit more advanced settings, but they are great. First I increase the number of clumping, which has a nice effect. Look at this, really nice. And of course real-time, because we are using the Eevee renderer. Then I also like to modify the roughness for the endpoints and some random roughness. Okay, that's all I wanted to change, just a few basic properties for getting started, and it already looks quite interesting. Okay, then we go here to the render settings, enable some ambient occlusion. Also, bloom could look very nice later on when we add a new light, and also screen space reflection. And what you can set here as well is the hair shape type. You can choose between strand and strip. Here you can see the difference. Both are interesting, but for the moment, I stick to strand, which is the default. Great, and now comes something really cool. We go to the particle edit, which is, yeah, an edit mode for the hair. Okay, first it looks like this. We see this black lines, and then I select this comb brush to really comb the hair. And as always, you can press the F key to change the size of the brush, or Shift and F to adjust the strength, and you can rotate the viewport and comb from every side. But now you could say, well, I only see these black lines. How can I say that it looks good in the end, but we are here in real-time rendering and the comb brush has an option which is called children, okay? A bool option, and when you enable it, you can see the result as a real-time render preview. Really amazing. Okay, now I'm combing this, but if it looks a bit too flat, you can select the puff brush. Increase the brush size a bit by pressing the F key and click here and there to make it look a bit more puffy. There are more brushes, for instance, for adding or smoothing the hair, and this one is for changing the hair length. Most brushes can be inverted when you hold the Shift key down while using them. Another brush is the cut brush, and I think the name says it all. You can use it for a nice haircut. Okay, but I think this one is not that nice, so we'll undo this. Alright, so let's render this. I press the 0 key on the numpad, so that I can see the scene through my camera. I choose a bit darker background here in the world properties. And when I press the F12 key, the scene and the hair is rendered. Okay, that's nice, but not too impressive. So let's go here to the render settings again and try the strip instead of the strand hair shape type. Yeah, I like it, but how about duplicating this and use the same one in a different color? So we just have to press Shift and D to duplicate the sphere, and then press G to move them to different locations, then press S to make them a bit smaller. Okay, then I go to the Material tab for the selected one, duplicate the material, and set the color to a red tone. Great, but they're still a bit too flat, so I use the puff brush again for both. Then add a sunlight, for example, to the scene, rotate it, set the color and increase the strength, and then again render it, and here we go. I'm sure you get the idea. So this was a getting started with Blender 2.8 hair. If you're interested in this topic, then let me know and I will create more detailed tutorials. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and support me as my patron. Follow me on my Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and I see you soon here on Jayanam.